Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield, joined now by Jill, Kate, and Gabby from Luscious Jackson. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you.
The new album is called Electric Honey, and you worked with Tony Mangiarian again on this one, which I think is great because he's someone that, do you always call him when you're about to do an album? Is he someone you think about when you feel like you think about him all the time.
I call him for dinner, I call him lunch.
I ran into him jogging on the West Side Highway on his cell phone.
So it just turns out you're like, hey, you know what?
He's always around and he's the best.
He's from the village too.
He's someone you've known for a long time.
He's a really good friend of ours for a long time.
Now you also have appearances like 25 Ton and Tony Visconti is an amazing guy. I mean, he produced almost virtually all the T-Rex and some of the most adventurous David Bowie albums. Were you fans of those records? Is that why you wanted to work with him?
Yeah. Those were our favorite records, the ones he's done.
Yeah, how did that come about, like actually collaborating with him?
How did that come about? Someone I know was working with him, Todd Youth, and he said, why don't you get Tony Visconti to produce some of your stuff? And we said, all right, sounds great. I didn't even know he's still around, actually.
We'd mentioned him because we liked his string arrangements on T-Rex and stuff like that.
So. Yeah, his drum sounds are awesome. Guitars, yeah.
Yeah, it's that slap drum sound.
We learned a trick, which we won't reveal.
You won't reveal. It turned out great, though, obviously.
Yeah, we have a song called Fantastic Fabulous, and Kate suggested Tony Visconti producing and Deborah Harry singing part of it. Deborah Harry from Blondie.
Right.
So, that was just like a magic combination that it all happened really fast and was very smooth.
That's pretty incredible, too. We've got lots more to talk about with Luscious Jackson. But right now, we've got a 120-minute debut from Powerman 5000. It's from the forthcoming album, Tonight, The Stars Revolt. And it's called When Worlds Collide. Brand new tonight at 120 Minutes. Matt Pinfield hanging out with Jill, Kate, and Gabby from Luscious Jackson. We were talking about On Electric Honey, Fantastic, Fabulous, and the fact that Debbie Harry did a sing on there, which I think is great. You played, you filled in for Clem Burke with Blondie on a show last year, actually,
yeah.
Playing drums, Kate. How did that come about? Is that kind of what made the connection?
Sort of, yeah. I mean, we had seen Debbie Harry at a couple of our shows early on, so we had heard rumors that she was a fan of ours, which was very thrilling because Blondie is probably one of our first favorite bands growing up. And I did this thing called Fraggle Rock, which is a monthly party, and they have a tribute night. And they had a Blondie tribute night, and I played drums for that. And Debbie Harry and Chris Stein came to that show. Then a couple months later, she called me up and said, we're doing a show, a surprise show at Tramps, and we're playing like four or five songs, and Clem can't make it. Can you play drums? I know you know the songs. And I was like, is this a joke?
Yeah. One of those surreal moments. Yeah.
Definitely. So, and we were in the middle of recording, and I said, can I take day off on Friday? And we played that show, and then a couple months later, we were recording the song and called her up.
That's
awesome.
That really worked out great. Now, speaking of other guests, Emmylou Harris, who's got quite a history and even did a little bit on your last record, I think, as well, does guest vocals on Ladyfingers.
Mm-hmm.
So you've started a relationship with her as well in the last couple of years.
Yeah, I mean, we've always loved country music and kind of roots, basic songs with acoustic guitars and harmonies. And people think, how did you guys hook up with Emmylou? What a weird combination. And to us, it just doesn't seem strange at all because we love so many kinds of music and... You know, she's one of the great singers.
She's also a huge music lover, too.
Of all kinds, yeah. She's into experimenting with new forms, and she's definitely not into just sticking with the country mold, you know?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Well, the synergy worked out really well on there, just the sound of all that. I'll be back with more Luscious Jackson, but right now, though, we've got to check out the top 10 singles in alternative music around America this week. Welcome back to 120 Minutes. It's Matt Pinfield hanging out with the ladies of Luscious Jackson. Speaking of guests on the record, who knew that Kim Hampton of the New York Liberty, you know, could sing? I mean, you have her on there, Friends. That's cool. Tell me how that came about. That's really interesting. I know you're basketball.
Yeah, we're big basketball fans and fans of the New York Liberty, who are our local WNBA team. And a couple times I went to the game and she was singing the national anthem. And such an incredible voice. And then I think we both saw this Inside Stuff special or something where she was singing in the club, and it was just one of those things like, wouldn't it be great if we had the New York Liberty come and sing our album?
Also, Kate was dying to meet them, so I thought that'd be a good way to get to know them. So
we tried to actually get a bunch of them to sing on the record, but she's actually the only one in town, really.
Yeah.
And she has such a great voice, so it worked out really well. And it's,
she was more than enough.
She was great. Yeah.
Obviously, you're a huge basketball fan, because you named yourself after you know, an ex-Philadelphia 76er mm-hmm. player, right? Luscious Jackson.
Tell us, Jill's doing.
Well, I'm not the biggest basketball fan in the group.
But she liked the name.
But the name was cool. It's actually Luscious Jackson.
Luscious, right.
And his nickname is Luscious, so.
Right. We've got a lot more to talk about with Luscious Jackson. Right now, we've got a video from one of the bands that competed in our Under the Radar Flying Indie contest a few weeks back. So check it out. Band reminds you a little bit of Tool, and so does the video. They're called Chevelle. It's from the album Point Number One. And this is Mia, brand new 120 Minutes.
Living with my six guns and I move along like a gangster, keeping the family strong with the mission of chaotic song, of the chaos, semi-automatic sisters. I might be strong, but don't call me mister. Playing with the status quo of the soul. Enjoy Babylon, chaos, chaos.
Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield here with Jill, Kate, and Gabby from Luscious Jackson. And this is the first record you made without Vivian. She left, I guess, shortly. Was it shortly after the last tour?
Mm-hmm.
How did that come up? I mean, what happened there?
Let's see. Vivian sort of hinted to me that she had had it with the touring life somewhere along the way of a Fever and Fever Out's tour.
Yeah.
And then she was nice enough to finish out the whole, you know, cycle with us. Mm-hmm. And we're all still friends and working on various projects together. She'd just rather be at home, you know?
Yeah, a little road weary.
For those who don't know, touring is pretty exhausting and not for everyone, you know?
Absolutely. Now, speaking of touring, you're going to do some Lilith Fair dates, right?
Yeah. Lilith Fair, mostly on the West Coast through Texas, and then we start on our own with Chiba Motto in the Midwest and Northeast.
And they're good friends of yours, so that'll be a good tour.
It'll be excellent.
We're very excited.
Excellent. Now, Tamara Davis did the new video for Ladyfingers. She's working with Ruka Saw, Boss Hawk, some cool stuff with.
Yeah, she's great.
She's been a friend of yours for a long time?
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
She did our first video, right? Or the second one?
She did both our first videos, Daughters of the Chaos.
What a great song.
And City Song.
Yeah.
And she's the one who came up with the bus idea, because we're dancing on a bus. And it actually is a New York City bus going through the streets of New York City. And we lit it up, and we had all the extras in there dancing, and people on the street were stopping and screaming and pointing. It was hilarious, especially in Times Square. Like, there was just mobs of people, you know.
Yeah, it was fun.
I bet people were just going crazy, and nobody else drove off the road.
Well, it's quite a sight, you know, if you can see
people dancing in a bus, yeah.
What the hell? It's really cool, yeah.
And then there's other people who just like, well, it's another day in New York City on the street. Right, when they see it, they're not as freaked out. But it looks great in the video as well. We're going to check that out right now. I want to thank you for coming by today.
Thanks, Max.
Good to have you tonight. Everyone at home should definitely check out the new album. It really grooves. It's called Electric Honey, as well as some of the earlier records like Fever In, Fever Out, Natural Ingredients, and In Search of Manny. And right now, let's take a look at the video we were talking about. From Electric Honey, Luscious Jackson, this is Ladyfingers. Thanks again for coming by.
Thank you.
Good to have you.